Okay, quickly grab everything together. Boom, boom, boom. Hi everyone, my name's Dallas and welcome to today's video. This is just going to be a mid-month check-in just to let you know what I have purchased and what I have read. So without further ado, I'm just going to jump in and do it. I think I mentioned this first book in my last update, and that was Ilona Andrews' Diamond Fire. This comes after the first three books in her Hidden Legacies series, which is a wonderful urban fantasy. I highly recommend it if you come across it. This starts the next phase of the series with the middle sister Catalina. This is her introductory novella into what will probably be the next few books about her. I really enjoyed it, but there was just something that was missing, and I actually think it had to do with the length. Because this is a novella, I think it's all of about, how many pages? It's 145 pages. There was not enough length in the story to completely flesh it out, and parts of it just went by really fast. But for what this is, it's actually quite enjoyable. I think I gave it 3.5 stars, I think, maybe. The second book I bought this month from my local Big W was not exactly an impulse purchase, but it's a book that I was hoping to put off for a little while, but when I went back, I think last week, and saw that there was only one copy left, I had to pick it up, and that was Flight or Fright, edited by Stephen King and Bev Vincent. This is an anthology full of stories basically about horrific things or terrifying things happening on flights, as far as I know. So I haven't gotten to any of this yet, but I do adore this cover. Let me know down below in the comments if you have read anything from this anthology, and I will hopefully get to it maybe a bit sooner. The third book is one that I picked up yesterday when I went into town. The catalogue said the book was out, there was nothing on the shelves, so I actually went up to the service desk and had them go fossick out the back in the pallets to find it, and that is Look Alive 25 by Janet Evanovich. This is of course the 25th book in her Stephanie Plum series, and after a couple of years where I've been a bit disappointed with some stories, some of them have had really weird sort of storylines.
A giraffe running through Trenton? Please.
This one, it's back to a more grounded mystery, although one of the characters from a previous book that has to do with a bit of paranormal has popped up again. That really was a bit odd, but I actually think it worked really well. We get a whole lot more of Ranger, which is always a good thing. Morelli takes more of a back seat. There are some great secondary characters. We of course get a lot of Lula. We actually surprisingly get more Hal in this one, which is great because he only pops up now and then and only for short little snippets in the books, but we see more of Hal, and the ending for this is really what I just want to mention. Usually every book that you get in the Stephanie Plum series follows the same formula: the beginning, the middle, and the end. Self-contained stories. If it wasn't for the fact that it's in a series, you could technically pick these up wherever you wanted to and you could follow what's going on. This one ends in a cliffhanger, and I was so surprised, and I am so here for it. The cliffhanger hopefully sets up book 26, because if we continue on with how the story finishes into the next book, it promises to be a really, really good book. So yeah, I'm just really surprised by this new tweaking of the format that Janet Evanovich has made in book 25. I would have thought she might have done this, you know, years ago in the series, but she's trying it now, and hopefully, fingers crossed, it works out and book 26 is amazing. Oh, and I read this also yesterday, so I gave this 4 stars. Okay, onto the books I already owned that I have read in the last week and a half. First one is Gwendy's Button Box. I know, surprise, I didn't think I would really be touching this one yet. It's part of the Castle Rock series, I suppose, technically, but it's set in the 70s, so when I realised that, I didn't feel too bad reading it. So far, I've only read The Dead Zone in the Castle Rock series. I was hoping to get at least most of the books before I started diving into them, but I picked this up, read it, and I think because I haven't gotten myself in depth in the Castle Rock world, that this was more enjoyable to me than it seems to be for a lot of hardcore King fans who have read everything he's ever written. I don't have any preconceived ideas about the Castle Rock series, so I found this one quite enjoyable. I loved the way that you follow... What's her name again? I love the way you follow Gwendy from a young teenager just transitioning out of what we in Australia would call primary school, I suppose, into high school, and how her life is changed by the little box that the man in black gives to her. It was just so much fun. I sped through this. There are some pretty dark moments for poor old Gwendy in this book, but in general, it was really well done. I almost wish it was just a little bit longer so I could find out what happened to her life next. And I gave this book 4 stars. The next book I picked up after Gwendy's Button Box was a little old copy of Bedknob and Broomsticks by Mary Norton. I won't go into this because I had a lot of problems with this. I loved the Disney movie as a child with Angela Lansbury, and I just assumed that that was how the book would go. The book is so different, but like I said, that's a rant for another video. And ultimately, while it was well written, I just did not connect with any of the characters really, so this one was a 2-star read from me. Next was Peril at End House by Agatha Christie. I've gotten a bit more into my Agatha Christie books at the moment. Maybe it's because of all the hot weather that's coming up in Australia, or it could be because when I went to my local Big W last Friday, I happened to find 3 of the seasons of Poirot discounted in a discount bin for $5 each. Thank you very much. I was really proud of myself for finding them too. So I've been binging Poirot for the last 4 or 5 days, and I'm just really into it at the moment, so I picked up Peril at End House, and I actually really enjoyed it. I think the ending of this book I actually enjoyed more than the twist in The Murder of Roger Ackroyd, so this was so enjoyable, 4 stars. And on to what I'm currently reading. I picked up Raffles by E.W. Hornung. I hope I pronounced his last name properly. If I didn't, I'm sorry. This is basically a classic crime novel from about the turn of the 19th century. It's just a gentleman thief. That's basically what it is. And in the first short story, you meet Raffles and how his old school chum, Bunny, I can't remember what his proper name is, but he's called Bunny, how he ends up being roped into Raffles' shenanigans. So this first story was mainly introductory deal, and I'm on to the second story, which is a costume piece, which I presume is about an elaborate, ornate piece of jewellery. We will see how it goes, and this promises to be a great little short story collection that I can dip in and out of over the summer. Another book that I just finished this morning was the Agatha Christie Book Club. This is by C.A. Larmer, and it's a modern murder mystery series. This book is basically about our main character, Alicia, who was part of a snooty book club that she detested, so when she quit that, her sister encouraged her to start her own book club. She was a bit stumped, and between them they decided on starting an Agatha Christie book club because they both loved Agatha Christie. This was really surprising to me. I just purchased it on a whim. I wasn't particularly looking for it. It's actually set in Sydney, Australia. Now, I'm not from Sydney, but I have been to Sydney once upon a time, and it was really fascinating to see an Agatha Christie type book set in Australia, because when I first saw this and saw the title, I naturally assumed it was going to be set in England somewhere, or perhaps maybe America. But no, it was set in Australia, and I am so there for that. This book followed actually quite a good Agatha Christie plot. You have the group of people, a set group of people, you know going in that one of them is the villain, so to speak, and shit hits the fan. One of their members, a woman called Barbara, goes missing, and then a few days later her husband is killed. There's all this intrigue about affairs and romance and scandals. You get to the end and of course there's the big reveal as Alicia plays the part of almost like a Miss Marple slash Poirot. And I was really enjoying it, so I'm going to continue on with the series. I think I gave this 3.5 stars. It was a really great introduction to the cast of characters and to the setting, and I was so surprised by this. So if you ever do see it and you love Agatha Christie, perhaps give this a go. You might enjoy it. If you do, let me know down below in the comments. I'd love to hear what you think of it. Now to what I am planning to read. And the first book is 3-Act Tragedy by Agatha Christie. This is just a little second-hand copy that I picked up, I think, a couple of years ago. It sounds interesting. It's basically a reverend who seldom drinks, is invited to a glittering soiree, and he indulges in a cocktail and falls over dead. There is no trace of poison, no motive for the murder, and so the case is closed. But then, an identical death at a London party with the same guest list presents Hercule Poirot with his most unusual mystery. In need of both clues and suspects, the masterful detective stages a dinner party of his own, at which death is the guest of honour. This sounds so interesting, and I can't wait to get into it. Okay, so that is my mid-month wrap-up. I've got a lot of books coming in the mail. I had a bit of a binge, I know. Merry Christmas to me early. Oops, no. I better leave you again because my camera battery is blinking at me, so I think it's going to die, so I'll wrap this up really, really quickly. Thank you for watching. Let me know in the comments below if you have read any of these books, and if you have, what you thought of them, or if you'd like to read them, let me know. And if you would like me to do a more in-depth review on one of them, also let me know that. What else? Thank you for watching. As I said, please like, comment, subscribe, all those things. And until I see you guys next time, happy reading.